I received a few days ago from China. Shenzhen Solution Company of Macrosilicon Microelectronics sent me one, a solution for USB3.0 capture card. Very, very small. Moreover, the IC is integrated into one. Hey, this is very difficult. We made this USB3.0 drive-free capture card 5 years ago. It looks like this. You see so many ICs in the middle. At least 5 or 6. Then just one over here will do it. This excites me so much. The reason I'm excited is to say, does he work well? Even if it is true, is it really USB3 or fake? China, Macrosilicon Company. He made this 2 years ago. USB2D capture card. Is also very small. What you see in the market like this? Capture card for RMB25 or NTD on 100. Or it looks like this. Or like this. Or it claims to be this very blue connector. Actually it's all. The one in mainland China. Macrosilicon Company. Capture card. Some of the capture cards we just saw. White label manufacturers. There are also some brand manufacturers that use that IC to make this capture card for that esports game. For example, like this one. He also made it with MS2109. He claims to say raw Nintendo games. Using this computer notebook. Unexpectedly, after 2 years, even made a USB3. Made this 2 years ago. This product, there are some problems in using electric toys because it is this USB2. Then when you play gamer player here, we'll take into account the video delay. Because a USB2 is limit is like that, you have to go USB3, access to computer without compression. This will result in lower video latency, but at that time, some manufacturers claimed that his latency is so low, so what? And then there are even some manufacturers. He claimed that the USB2 is obviously a USB2 IC. He said he is a USB3. He just needs to replace his head with a blue hole. In fact, the previous MS2109 IC is actually a USB2. Many manufacturers deliberately say that he is 3. Until recently, all I got was MS2130, the next generation of MS2109. This time it is real USB3. Not made by the manufacturer. It was made by the planner. What is a solution provider? Let me explain. A solution provider is like saying you're selling flour. I claim my flour can make French bread. Then I will make this flour from French bread. With this oil. And the ratio of this sugar is done. I'm going to promote my flour. I'll actually make a French bread. Say hey to the maker of this bread. This is my French bread. Try it. That's right. This is that. The sample from the flower factory. Tell those manufacturers hey try it. I'm honored that I also received a test like this. Those who will actually get the samples will not be so fast. It should be made by the manufacturer. But I think it's pretty fast. Should be at the end of the year. If this product really comes out on the market, judging from his high degree of integration, maybe a white label capture card with a retail price of $200 is possible. At this time, these brand manufacturers, including our company, we'll also face a very big challenge. Then our company will not do such a thing. Why? Because this thing is already highly integrated. Already a standardized product. We will not make standardized products. I shoot a video today. I'm still very happy to share that. The real function of this MS2130. Then I won't intentionally say bad things or good things. I'll give you a real test. When we were making capture cards in 2012, there is no one IC like this time to get it done. When we were doing capture cards, I have to use IC string to string. There are 4 ICs strung together. The first is the RX of HDMI. DRX means that after he eats the HD signal, convert it to that UV video format, the uncompressed video format. Then, in fact, the video format at this time, you can directly throw it into the USB bridge IC. USB bridge is USB. The IC connected to the computer side, just throw it in. But in fact it can't be like this. Because of the USB bridge IC made in the early days, he is only 8-bit, only 8 legs. Then this DRX comes out with 16 feet. Here is 8. So you have to string an IC in the middle. It is a video scaler IC. Its function is to 16 pins of DRX are converted into 8 pins like this. What about other than that? It also has a function, that is, it can make the resolution of your HD input follow. The resolution of the output is event independent. For example, you input for HD. You can output HD. Input is HD. Output can be for HD. So HD input resolution and output USB resolution is independent event. I'll show you the computer OBS demonstration later. Then what about the Blu-ray player as the video source? I first use for HD video source, then switch to HD. Okay, let's get to the computer first. Connect the source to computer. Okay, what resolution are you seeing now? I now adjust the multimedia player box to HD. HD is good, then what? I play a video. When you look over here, you can choose to capture the card here. You see I choose for HD now. My source is HD. I output I can choose HD no problem. Then I choose for HD and there is no problem. I have no problem choosing VGA. Well, this is called the function of the scaler. Of course, there is this IC with this scaler added. Its video latency will increase. Later, when someone was making a capture card, he put this bridge, improved to it 16-bit. So you dare actually let the RX lose 16-bit there actually. It's okay to throw it to him. No problem. But the question is, D is for HD in, the output is for HD. HD input, HD output. He can't do it. Interleave the conversion of a single event. For the MS2130, it has been converted. Where is the USB bridge? USB bridge IC, he is in this MS2109. Their first generation IC was USB2. What is the difference between USB2 and USB3? The difference between USB2 and USB3 lies in the bandwidth of the USB. USB2 is so small, USB3 is so big. If you are so old, you can then take your original. I decided to throw the smelly data into your computer. But USB2 is so small you have to compress it. That compression is usually. This is called MJPG. It looks good. That compression has two major disadvantages for this computer. The first is to say that because it is compressed, so after you enter the computer is still unlocked. If it is easy to solve, the first biggest problem is its CPU usage will increase. Also, the picture quality might be a little bit worse, but I think the picture quality should not feel so good. Well, I'm not a shortcoming. The second biggest problem is video latency. Well, the early days, that MS2109 is his first generation. This one. Someone in the first generation used this IC to make. Claim to say raw. You can play this electronic toy on your laptop. This is what you can raise on your own fundraising platform. A lot of this capture card. What about the other USB2? Then they claimed that his video latency is 70 or how much? In fact, their testing methods are all wrong. My real test is about 100 ms. So many. Then we will become low latency today. For electric toys, such a capture card, we are bound to become USB3. Then this capture card made with USB3. Its advantage is that its bandwidth is large enough. So I will drop you. Send the uncompressed signal to the computer. The computer does not need to be unlocked. So the delay will be lower. But the problem is that he has been disturbed by this one. How much will it drop? We still have to be tested. We are going to test this one. The delay part of the interception card of MS2130. My idea is this. I use this computer to broadcast a stopwatch. Then what? Connect the HDMI to the capture card. Then this interception card is controlled by this one. Computer to capture the screen. Then let's compare the difference between this picture and this picture. Open the MCAP of the computer. Then grab this USB video. Then choose U60 FPS and 4HD. Then we start playing. For the audience, you can just press the pause button to watch. What is the actual delay? Our actual test is about 50 to 70 ms. Then such a video delay should be acceptable for video game apps. Then we have, I have seen a capture card made by others. He doesn't even have this, just this screen. For the 16-bit, throw him the 16-bit. That one can make a delay of about 30 ms. But the problem is that you don't have the disadvantage of adding a scaler. It's how you get in and how you get out. Why? Each has its pros and cons. He's a seesaw. Okay, than what we just said. Another important part of the capture card is the sound. Because the sound of HDMI is divided into this 44.1 kHz. What else 48 kHz? 32 kHz. What is the different sampling rate of 36 kHz? For example, your incoming signal today is 48. On the computer side, it is necessary to set it to 48. If the two sides don't agree, then your voice will. There will be beep beep beep. Then add this audio sampling rate IC, then it is. I don't care what the sampling rate of your front end is. I convert everything to 48 kHz. Take the first generation of them as an example. They all turn into 96 kHz. For this time, he converted all to 48 kHz. We now use this multimedia player to simulate various audio sampling rates. 48 kHz, 44.1 and 36 and so on. Then come to test to see if there is any problem with the sound. Blueberry actually plays this different sampling rate. Our site has 8 kHz, 16 kHz, 48x, 44.1 kHz. We start with 8 kHz.
看一下你的功力哦，他累了，他不行。
Sound is normal. 16 kHz.
所以
the sound is also normal. 48 kHz. 44.1 kHz. I'm using another capture card now. This is someone else's capture card. The processing of this sound sampling rate has not been done yet. See what happens. Let's connect this directly to the computer and see. Set the resolution of his UVC output. Which ones? Let's study two places. The first one is to go in USB3 mode. The second is to study the USB2 mode. USB3 mode. Just put this. Insert the capture card into the USB3 connector of the computer. Okay, let's try. Then we open the computer MCAP to have a look. Ah, you see this is the screen of the capture card. Then look. Here is a place to get the video capture pin. You can see it in USB3 mode when it can reach up to 60 frame rate. Then MJPG can also reach 60 FPS. In this way, there are so many resolutions, up to 4 HD. Then, minimum is VGA. The same reason, what happens when I drop it to USB2? You just need to connect an extra USB2 extension cable. It becomes USB2 mode. Plug in. Come in. Let's go to the computer MCAP to have a look. You saw the same picture. Look here. There is a video capture pin here. You see he will become MJPG UV. He also has UV, but UV becomes several, 5 FPS only. The maximum number of MJPG is 50 FPS. Have you seen 4 HD up to 50 FPS? Then compare him with the previous generation. The previous IC generation had 30 FPS at 4 HD. He's up to 50 FPS. Good like this. Next, let's test the compatibility of this branch on each platform. I'm connecting a camera now. Connect the capture card of this MS2130 to this Samsung Android phone. It is a USB3 port. Connect in. Then grab the card and plug it in. The video source is connected to a camera. Look at it. I play this like this. You see there is a picture or there is a picture. Then you look at the resolution part. Can he really go to YUV with no YUV 30 FPS? 60 FPS YUV can also capture. There is no problem. See, then this is a question for me to test Android phones. That is, he is called that Comeroffee Live in this live broadcast software. Currently Comeroffee Live is a bit of a problem. It's just that the screen will shake a little. Try it. You see his screen shakes. Look, you see a flash. Shake it. That's how the app software decompresses the problem of MJPG decoder. I believe this camera off leave. It should be made for this capture card in the future. Slightly improved. This can be improved by software. APP can be changed. You can also use it on this Mac computer. Apple computer. This is Raspberry Pi. I want this one. This capture card of MS2131. On this Raspberry Pi use. I connect this D. Then connect the mouse. Plugged in. Open. Okay, let's turn on the Raspberry Pi. I connect this capture card to it. Next to the hole connected to a USB3 port, here is the blue connector. The video is received from this camera and goes to the camera. Open it. We open the APP. Open it. Then you can see that there are options. You can choose MJPG. You can also choose UV. Here and here you can choose 60 FPS. Play. Nice to see. Oh, like this. His latency on the Raspberry Pi will be a bit higher. Okay, let's test MJPG. Here is a MJPG. Then choose not too high and choose 30 FPS. Play. Good. So this one, MS2130, can be used on this Raspberry Pi. Macrosilicon Microelectronics made this highly integrated solution of USB3 capture card. I guess it is expected to be available in the market by the end of the year. The white label market will see first. Will you see? About USD10. The person who invested in this manufacturer. It may be some manufacturers of keyboards, mice and microphones. When we were doing it before, you can see that there are so many ICs. String to string to string to string to string. His bar is very high. Now only one IC. And add some passive components and you're done. The threshold is very low. I guess this one will be in this hardware store in the future. There are some other things that can be found in any stationary store. For those of us, for these manufacturers who specialize in the live broadcast field, how will we face this kind of capture card in the end? Maybe they will sell books and give away capture cards. Free capture card for selling courses or free capture card for teaching. We will not simply develop this kind of capture card. What about the price war of USD10? You sell one for USD8. Can't even earn a bento. Those who want to sell said. But if it's a gift, of course. Then maybe there is an attractive place. Pay this one out. We'll give some current live broadcast feels. A big shock to the brand owner. The capture card market will be shaken up this year. Will the big factory invest in this one? It's a very important indicator. If the big brand manufacturers that do live broadcasting also use such ICs, how to set his price? And how on earth did he pack it? Is it what I just said? Sell books and get a capture card. Sell courses and get a capture card. This is big. For big factories. All for one in a dilemma. Just think in the right direction. Anyway. This one will start a revolution. For our company, how do we face this IC? We will not take the initiative to make such hardware, but we will use our live teaching. Then send you this capture card is no problem. We are on hardware. We still use advanced. Or this capture card for special applications is the main. If you need such a simple capture card, just go to the hardware store and buy it. Because when the hardware store stationery store, guaranteed to see, USD 10 video capture card. The effect is not bad.